Bon, à l'époque, vous avez critiqué un peu les bombes, c'est là, ouais, les sables.
How's my shirt?
Fine. Sure.
Cut that
out. So, you are Canadian? Canadian.
I was born in Canada.
Okay. And you are teaching?
I'm teaching in Germany at the present time.
You are teaching video?
No, I'm a professor for painting and technical built medium, as they call it in German.
Built medium?
Yeah, but my class is basically conceptual art. And the students are free to choose
which medium?
Their medium.
And you teach in German?
Yes, believe it or not.
That's very unusual for Americans.
No, there are a lot of Americans teaching in German.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. You see more and more American professors here in Europe. I think,
yes, but usually they are not very polyglot. They just talk English. You learn German?
Well, I don't speak very good German, but enough to manage. I've been in Germany 5 years, so it would be impolite not to at least attend. Je peux aussi un peu de français, mais ça fait longtemps que je n'ai pas parlé. Now I'm too old to really, when I speak German, when I try to speak French, I mix German with French.
And so can you make a brief description of your work here?
This work here, this is a piece called Arctic Circle. It was made last year by a Swiss artist, Felix Stephan Huber, and myself. And the purpose of the project was to travel in the last remote natural wilderness on Earth, northern Canada, and at the same time to travel on the so-called data superhighway.
Okay, so it was a confrontation between nature and civilization.
Well, confrontation is a pretty tough word. It is critical in a sense of this apparent discrepancy between real reality and virtual reality. So it was an investigation into that, but it really was more of an investigation into loneliness. I mean, to work in the new media, to work on the internet, it's a very lonely experience. One might be connected, but if you've had any experience yourself sitting in front of a computer screen, there's a certain feeling of loneliness. And we found that that was a rather similar feeling to one that a city person feels when they go back into the wilderness. We don't belong anymore in a natural environment. It seems paradoxical to say that, and it was a very sad realization that I made. When you sit in a place and you look out, and you realize that for 1,500 kilometers, there is not a single sign of human being, sign of civilization. It's a very lonely field.
But there are roads.
There's only one road.
One.
And it's a gravel, it's a dirt road that goes up to the Arctic Ocean.
But internet, in a way, is also making people closer.
Yeah, it's still a little bit of a utopia vision. We had big experiences with our mail form. We set up what's called a listserv, which is an interactive email exchange form. And like any relationship, you have to maintain it, you have to nurture it. So it's not in itself naturally more communicative, it just basically takes more time. If you have 1,000 colleagues to whom you must send a message every week, you can spend 25 hours a day, 8 days a week, answering your email. And this is a problem.
So you're not lonely?
We found it very lonely. We had very little response at the beginning. We were expecting much more interaction, but the World Wide Web is different from the early days of internet, which was all email. And email text-based communication seemed to be much more two-way. Now that there's multimedia on the internet, people tend to consume, and the information just flows into your computer, and then you surf to the next site instead of responding to the site that you're looking at. It tends to be less interactive now, unfortunately. It's becoming more
one way. So I'm afraid it's enough.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I was aware of how we are.